Welcome to part 14 of my webcast series about a mission flown by the Ada Air Force on December 24th, 1944. In this episode, we will take a look at a second force attack on their assigned targets. One very high-ranking German officer apparently witnessed the attack of the second force. None other than Adolf Hitler himself was at the Führerhauptquartier Adlershorst. This Hauptquartier was situated just 6 miles away from both Merzhausen and Kirchhons, which were targeted by the 2nd Force. Also, the planned routes for all of the 2nd Force came very nearby the Führerhauptquartier. Ettinghausen was the target of two groups of the 1st Division. 1st A and B flown by the 381st and 398th Bomb Group. But as mentioned in part 9.2, the 1st B group was delayed because of accidents and went on with plan B. So it was only the 1st A group, flown by the 381st, that actually attacked their primary target. From the lead bombardier mission narrative, the following quote: "At the IP, the brief turn was made. I could not pick up the target because we were a considerable distance from it at this point. However, we proceeded on course, and when a few landmarks were identified, the assigned area was picked up and a bomb run was started. The run was relatively short, but I had enough time to synchronize perfectly before bombs away. I sighted so as to place the bomb pattern around the MPI and with a 75-foot interval meter setting. This necessitated aiming short." This photo shows Ettinghausen seconds before the impact of the bombs dropped by the lead squadron. A smoke trail from the smoke marker is visible at the bottom of the photo to the left of the letter E of Ettinghausen. A few moments later, this photo was taken from a ship flying in the low squadron. It clearly shows a successful attack on the landing ground of Ettinghausen. Both the 1st and 41st Combat Wing dispatched a single group to attack Kirchhons. The 1st C group, which was a composite, attacked Kirchhons around 14:29. This photo shows the impact of the bombs dropped by the 91st D Squadron flying as lead. The second group to attack Kirchhons was flown by a composite group led by the 384th. This picture, taken from a 384th ship flying in the low squadron, shows the target was well hit. In total, 6 squadrons attacked Kirchhons. This bomb plot shows the center of concentrations of bombs. It shows that the entire landing ground was hit. Three groups of the 40th Combat Wing had Giessen as their primary target. The first group to attack Giessen was the 40th A group, flown by the 92nd Bomb Group. This is a series of photos taken by a 92nd B-17 flying in the low squadron. It shows the group made a successful attack on their primary target, cratering the landing ground and hitting some of the buildings. Some 5 minutes after attack of the first group, the second group attacked Giessen. This group was flown by the 306, and the picture shows the moment their bombs hit the target. Black holes can be seen on the landing ground, this being the result of the first group attack. The last group attacking Giessen was the 305th. What follows are 3 quotes from the bombardier reports of the lead, low and high squadrons. From the lead squadron: saw target area before IP was reached. Turned on to target with drift preset. Halfway down run, the group ahead hit the target and smoked in the aiming point. used hangar next to aiming point to kill raid and cores. Bombs went away at point 37 tangent dropping angle and 22 degrees of left drift. Estimate of bombing results, fair. From the low squadron, IP was made good. Visibility was very good. I picked up the target about 30 miles away. Had a very good bomb run. This run was flown manually. The target was difficult to pick up due to smoke from previous bombing. Nothing definite could be identified because I aimed at where I thought the aiming point to be using surrounding checkpoints. Estimate of bombing results, fair. From the high squadron, there were no clouds in the target area and not much haze. The bomb smoke southwest of the target was heavy and it obscured the southwest edge of the target. I did pick up my briefed aiming point and had about 4 minutes for a good bomb run. Estimate of bombing results, good. A total of 4 groups had Nidda as their primary target. One group of the 41st Combat Wing and 3 of the 94th Combat Wing. The 94th A Group, flown by the 457th, took off in the afternoon but were recalled once they were over the North Sea. Only one B-17 went on and attacked a target of opportunity. The 94th B Group, flown by the 401st, went on with Plan B, and we will see them later on this episode. The 351st flew as the 94th C Group, and like the A Group, they too were recalled once they were over the North Sea, flying in the afternoon. The only bombs dropped on Nidda were those of the 306 Bomb Group D Squadron. The following series of photos shows the attack on Nidda, and it can be seen they hit their target, cratering the landing ground. Other bombs fell some 6 miles from the intended target. These were dropped by both 92nd D and 305th D squadrons, both caused by the fact they misidentified the target. The bombs were dropped near the village of Bellersheim. The strike photo shows the attack of the 305th D squadron. This is from the bombardier report of the 305th Bomb Group, Low Squadron, 40th D. Made IP good. Started run on briefed heading. On first attempt, target was not seen, so we made a turn to the left and headed toward the city of Gießen. Just as we entered the defense zone of the city, we made another turn to the left and held it till we were on a heading of 137 degrees, heading back to the target. The bombardier picked up what he thought was the target and dropped the bombs. At that time, the lead of the 40FD dropped bombs which went into the target area with good results. It was at this time that I knew I picked the wrong target. Two groups of the 41st Combat Wing and one of the 1st Combat Wing attacked the landing ground of Merzhausen. It was the 41st A Group, flown by the 303rd Bomb Group, that released their bombs on Merzhausen around 14:48. Although the quality of the picture is not that great, one can see the impacts of the bombs in the center. Second group to attack Merzhausen were those of the 379th Bomb Group, flying as the 41st B Group. This shows the center of concentration of bombs dropped on Merzhausen. Clearly shown are two concentrations that were off target for reasons unknown. These were dropped by the 379th lead and high squadrons. It was the 91st Bomb Group, flying as the 1st Combat Wing D Group, that was the third and final group to attack Merzhausen. From the bombardier's narrative of the lead squadron, 1st D Group, the following. Target, hangars on northeast side of landing field near Merzhausen, Germany. Lead aircraft 478 was flown on AFCE. bombs were away at 1453 on a magnetic heading of 64 degrees. Indicated altitude was 22,000 feet. Indicated airspeed was 150, and the length of bomb run was 3 minutes. Bombing was visual and observed results were good. This photo, taken from a ship in the lead squadron, does show the bombs indeed came down in the northeastern side of the airfield. Due to delays back in the UK, some groups were ordered to fly Plan B with Koblenz as their target. Groups ordered to fly Plan B were the 94th B Group, flown by the 401st, joined by the 1st B Group, flown by the 398th, following in trail, and 8 aircraft of the 457th Group that took off in the morning and were told to tack on with the 401st. At around 15:19, the 401st Group dropped their bombs on Koblenz. This photo shows the bombs and smoke marker some seconds after they were dropped. It seems though that not all the bombs were dropped, likely due to a malfunction inside the aircraft. Some moderate and accurate flak was encountered on a bomb run. These two photos, taken on this raid, shows the 398th with the bomb bay door open with flak explosions nearby. One bombardier was killed by shrapnel. From the 398th Bomb Group Bombardier report, the following quote: was only shown one picture of target at briefing and I did not receive a target folder. Interfollow meter setting was 75 feet, followed by salvo. I wanted a large dispersion of bombs because of the uncertainty of the actual AP. Rest of the squadron dropped early on premature release. The deputy and lead had a signal for bombs away with an Eldis lamp. The deputy cracked up on takeoff and a spare was used in its place. On the bombing run, seeing the sun shining off the upper turret and thinking it was the signal, the deputy dropped his bombs early, resulting that the entire squadron had an early premature release. This photo shows the strike of the low squadron 1st Combat Wing. It shows that their bombs came down in an open field. This concludes the attack of the 2nd Force on their targets. In the next episode, we will take a look at a 3rd Force and their attack on their assigned targets.